Abe Lincoln has overlooked Bascom Hill for more than 100 years. The statue worn from grads climbing up to get a picture. But what he symbolizes for marginalized students isn't land-grant universities or even emancipating slaves.
He was also very publicly anti-black. Just because he was anti-slavery doesn't mean he was pro-black. He has said a lot in his presidential campaigns, his fourth presidential campaign speech. He said that, you know, there should be an inferior and a superior, and he believes that white people should be the superior race.
Let's blow up the Lincoln Memorial!
Following his wife's death, Jefferson began a relationship with her half-sister and maid, Sally Hemings. Jefferson fathered 6 children with Hemings and kept the entire relationship secret while continuing to publicly denounce the personhood of black Americans. Jefferson freed several members of the Hemings family, including his children with Sally, while refusing to free anyone else. Despite enslaving over 600 people, Jefferson only freed 10, 5 during his life and 5 in his will, all members of the Hemings family.
Let's blow up the Jefferson Memorial!
And Jefferson Health.
George Washington was born in 1732 into a society where slavery was an accepted fact of life. When he was 11, he inherited 10 slaves, and by the time he died in 1799, had over 300 slaves on his estate.
Let's destroy the Washington Monument!
In 1800, John Adams, the nation's second president, became the first president to live in Washington, D.C., the new capital city. He resided in the White House, which was still under construction and being built by enslaved laborers.
Let's blow up the White House!
Born on the 2nd of November, 1636, in Bristol, England, Edward Colston became an extremely successful merchant and trader. In 1680, the controversy begins when Colston became a member of the Royal African Company. This company was an English mercantile company, established by the ruling House of Stuart and held a monopoly in gold, silver, ivory, and, most importantly, slaves. During Colston's time in the company from 1680 to 1692, 84,000 Africans were sold into slavery into the Americas, 19,000 of which died on the voyage. Though he left the company in 1692, he continued trading slaves privately until his retirement in 1708. After serving as MP for Bristol from 1710 to 1713, Colston died in 1721 at the age of 84, comfortably in his home. 174 years later, in 1895, a statue was erected in his honor in Bristol city center. Using the revenue he gained from his years as a merchant, Colston donated untold sums to charity. The amount he gave is unknown, as Colston remained modest about this. However, it's believed that he is responsible for the construction of most of the entire city of Bristol.
Let's blow up Bristol!
Come on.